guys in here. Once I swing around here, one of my favorite things to do here is like this. Up here, I can either sit just like this over top of the head and pinch his, like pinch his chest and back with my arm here, and I can turn this into a Kimura here. If you want to just keep going with the momentum, which I recommend doing if you're going to attack this arm like this, literally come here, like this. This knee is just up here, pound the back side. I don't want to be too far away from this. Everything's tight and close. From here, the way I'm finishing it, and for whatever reason you can't get the finish, there's a couple of things you gotta check on. Make sure your knees are pinched tight together here like this. Make sure both of your heels are curling towards your butt. And then from here, you pull his wrist more over your lower side here. It's what they call the south side here. The one that's closest to his feet. You don't have to pull it straight back. Don't try to pull it this way, just kind of letting them out a little bit. Pull it that way. You want to make sure that his thumb is facing opposite of your chest. So if I'm here hugging his wrist like this, his thumb is, I don't want to be like this, like how he has like that. I don't want to be this way either. I want to be opposite of my chest. My chest is here, thumb is that way. Alright. So one more time. Like I said, he locks me up. I know what he's going for. I feel this position a lot. I'm right here, taking my palm, driving his elbow in. Bringing it down. Scooting my hips away, bringing my elbow between my head and his head. Come here. Taking his arm, cranking down on his height, turn it over here. Using my head, bringing my head up here to help leverage on his arm here. Like I said, while I'm here, this is a good spot to land. Land a couple good shots. Boom, boom. As he's curling up, this knee gets close here. This one steps around to his back. I want to set down to the most here. I don't want to set just to here if I do this. It's not going to work. I'm trying to go here and then go. Tighter all it is jammed up, the better. Here, like I said, I'm keeping this arm close to my chest. Other arm, if I'm here like this, other arm coming to the wrist to pull it out. If I'm like this, this arm comes to the wrist to pull it out. If I pull like this, it's better for me finishing my arm lock. I just slide the hug up the arm. I don't let this go. Slide up, start a hit, do a curl towards the butt. Just from here, after I got out of this, I ended up here. Like I said, make sure this knee gets in close. This is cranking down, all right? I got strikes here, his head curls up, when his head curls up like this, and I got his arm under control, this is prime time to do it. Step around, boom. Put your chin kind of line up with his shoulders, the shoulder blades, feel like that. Turn this like this, I'm going to rotate up on the foot. Then from here, I can sit this foot straight down. All this, like I said, I don't want to sit here loose like this, giving them a little bit of space, making the arm bar looser. Making all my feet really tight, so when I push my foot. Like I said, I'm going on, slides up.
I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to do it.
Okay, so all this is going to be crazy. I'm saying, all this is going to be crazy.
been a great day.
I didn't get on.
All right.
You're going to be that guy.
I have to go belly down with it. Maybe, oh, maybe it's because you're not flat.
I wanted to box when I was younger, but shit, I ain't had no. My mama couldn't afford this shit. So now I'm older to afford it, I'm doing it myself.
Get a motherfucker. Come on,
As soon as you get that jump real good, it's over with. Like, they ain't got no, they ain't got no other option but to tap, or you're gonna break it.
It's the same thing with soccer pro actually too. They said it's all the way around. Soccer pro.
I mean, I do.
The soccer goal is the position that you only get from me. But that also encouraged him to go back down. Like, instead of him just sitting up taking his punishment, it encouraged him to come back down this way and try to defend himself. Another thing I'm doing, I got a lot of pressure cranking the shoulder down like this. This one of those ones, like, if he didn't react to it, I could submit him. The thing that stops me from being able to submit him is when he reacts and goes down like this. When he's like this, like, I can't get enough torque on his shoulder. If he were to sit up like this, I could get enough torque on his shoulder like this if he's just being like super stubborn and not letting me do it. But if I'm here, cranking down, like I said, if I'm here, punching, I'm punching. If I have to, go ahead, go back up, close it up. If I have to and I know I want to hit this move, I'll come through here and I'll pull his arm out like this. Look. At the very least, it's best case scenario, shoulder and hip is on the mat. It's a necessity that his shoulder is down. At least here has to happen. Shoulder at least has to be down. Right? That's one thing that's gonna tighten you up. Another thing is when I hit the spin, I'm not trying to like walk around or run around and get here like that. It's just two steps, alright? And technically it's not even two actual, it's a two-part process. One step, two-part process. The only step I'm doing is I'm stepping from here to here. Alright? If I want to, I can just step a little bit deeper to make it feel better. So I, like, I'm not like, for me, but making it to where like I'm gonna use like more mobile here. Alright? what I'm doing here is I'm not stepping anymore. My feet are gonna pretty much stay in the same spot. I'm just taking my body and I'm closing it like this. That's part of why I want everything down, so we can trample it. Boards up, we'll trample it. Literally, from here, I'm stepping here, keep myself pinched in tight here, and I'm gonna rotate. Come here, my feet are staying pretty much in the same spot. I'm rotating down. Here, I'm couple of things that's gonna help you out to make that tighter is one, like I said, get them pinned down first. Best case scenario, both hip and the shoulder is down just like this. The density, I have to have that shoulder and I have to be there. Two, go ahead, back up for a second. I'm staying active on the balls of my feet here. I don't want to be here like this. Talk about this when you're in someone's guard. You don't want to be here. Same thing here, but you're not as mobile. You want to balls here like this. You guys already thought I was on my feet. If I'm like this, with this foot flat like that, I'm a lot less mobile when it comes to me trying to hit this. Like, I'm like, all right. Like that. First, if I was here in the first place, if I was already here in the first place, active on the ball and quit. I can rotate a lot more on this. Like this. Instead of me being here trying to. So I'm here. Bottoms of my feet are on the mat. How the human body is trying to move. Not trying to walk on top of my feet. I'm trying to move around when I'm on the bottom of my feet like that. Alright. Those are the things that's going to make it tighter. One more time. Make sure it is tighter body than that. When I hit this, like I said, one step. I don't have to do multiple steps here. Keep it a crank down, take just one step, all the way down. Once I get in a good position that I want, say if I didn't feel like I was good there, I just bring it up. Alright? And from here, it's just a rotation. My feet are pretty much staying in the same spot. My knees and my hips are rotating like this. That's it. Alright, that makes sense to everybody?
It
should make everybody feel a little bit tighter and feel a little bit smoother like that. I'm literally just here. I've got to crank, step past, and from here, once I sit here, I'm not stepping anymore. Alright, everybody got it? Alright, let's go ahead. Let's get back to work with this, alright? I don't know what you're saying. Oh, alright. It's bumping too, I guess.
Oh, okay. Okay. Now I know. I get confused sometimes.
Obviously, like, if someone knows that that's coming, they're going to, like, just, they're going to put their heart on it. You know what I'm saying? So, it's the same thing with the armbar. You know, like, when you do those punches, that's it's a time that's synonymous right after you're done with the punches, like, or in between, actually. Yeah. Yeah. By the time like, the last punch starts, that transition starts. That's how you know, that's how you think you get used to punching. In Memphis, I don't even know if there's a Hispanic population.
Yeah, it is.
There
is?
It is. So you're saying that like you've been out and about, you never saw like a Latino,
I'm gonna have one of my grandpa's.
Alright, you see what comes out.
one of my grappling tournaments, I hit actually a couple of my head got hit down a good day.
I mean, for real.
That's too bad. Heels on, man. I know
this shit.